Are you a terminal operator looking to expand your terminal or looking to increase operational efficiencies by implementing RMGs or RTGs and you don't know where to start with? Or maybe are you an intermodal operator and you're looking to compare which of these two equipment will benefit more or achieve your operational KPIs for your intermodal terminal? Stop looking around. My name is Christopher and today I will share with you some pros and cons about RTGs and RMGs. Are you ready? Let's go for it. So let's start with the RMGs and let's go through the pros over here. As you may see, with RMG we increase safety. And why do we increase safety? It's because you got a better operation segregation, and by this I mean, as you may see over here, normally you will be serving different horizontal transportation below the cantilevers. Normally you can serve the land side below one cantilever, the water side below the other cantilever. You know, you can also segregate external flows for internal flows, so you will get this flexibility. When it comes to the intermodal operation, you will normally see also that you will be serving internal or external between the cantilevers, and you will be serving the rail between the legs. It all depends of your specific case, but it do enable a better operational segregation. Also in the intermodal, you will be doing this rotating of the containers quite efficient, because normally you could adapt here to the RMGs this rotating trolley. And also, if you are evaluating automation, that's a proven concept. And as I always mention, you just need to keep in mind what is your way of working, how are you currently deploying those equipment in your yard, or what is the automation level you're expecting to achieve. So now let's go into the cons of the RMGs. And yes, we got a higher capex compared to the RTG. That's well known. As you know over here, that the RMG will be fixed to rails. That's due to the nature of the equipment. It will be also a higher infrastructure capex. According to your terminal, you will need to evaluate piling and also the rail tracks for the RMGs. And if you are currently planning to automate an RMG, and according to the age of the RMG, the retrofit may be a little bit higher. So now let's go into the pros of the RTGs. And you know, the RTG is quite popular worldwide, and this is due to the mobility and flexibility of this equipment. Considering the capex over here, yes, it will be quite lower compared to the RMG. Basically over here, you will not need to invest in rails. When it comes to the intermodal application, yes, this is also equipment you can use at intermodals, not only at sea terminals. When it comes to the power source, yeah, we got the electric and hybrid solutions. They are still diesel RTGs, but more and more we are seeing that the hybrid and electric solutions are the most wanted in the market. And it can also be automated, and as I always told you, you just need to keep in mind how is your way of working and what automation level you want to achieve with this RTG. So now let's go into the cons of the RTG. And well, as his name mentioned over here, RTGs, rubber tire guarantees, those rubber tires normally limit the size and the lifting capacity of containers over here, so that's something to keep in mind. It's a reality that for the intermodal applications, the RTGs, most of the RTGs are not designed to gantry travel with load. That's something to keep in mind. And when it comes to rotating containers, you know, you can do that, but at the headlock level. So you need to keep in mind that it will be probably a little bit more slower compared to the RMG that will be rotating 360 the whole trolley. And when it comes to the retrofit to automate an old RTG, yeah, probably it will be quite high. But as I always mention, you need to compare what is the cost benefit of automating an old RTG, or if it makes sense to invest in a new equipment. So hope now you got a clear view between the rail mounted gantries and the rubber tire gantries over here. And remember, it's not only about the equipment, it's also understanding your way of working, what are your eco-efficient KPIs, what are your operational needs. And based on those, you can find the best solution. So let me know in the comments below which other pros and cons you will add to these two equipments, and don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to the channel.